Failing to look at what you are drawing is one of the most fundamental and most common errors an art student can make. Many students attempt to draw things the way they think they should look rather than the way they actually do look. The only way to record shape, proportion, and detail accurately is to look at the source of information. Forms, shadows, and details are hard enough to replicate when they are right there in front of you. If you have to make them up, they appear even less convincing. In order to produce an outstanding observational drawing, you must observe. Your eyes must continually dance from the piece of paper to the object and back again, not just once or twice, but constantly. Many artists use blind contour continuous line drawings as an exercise to warm up before a drawing session to familiarize themselves with their subject. This type of drawing exercise is a drawing from observation in which the artist directs their sight to the contour or the outline of the subject. In addition, the artist does not look at their drawing paper or lift the point of their pencil from the paper until the drawing is complete. Julia Kay is an American artist living, working, and exhibiting her work in San Francisco for the last 20 years. On her blog, The Daily Portrait Project of Julia Kay, she explores the self-portrait using different drawing techniques and exercises, such as blind contour continuous line drawings. These are some examples of her work. I can see clearly now. Now, I'm going to show you how to create a blind contour continuous line drawing. First, you want to find a subject. You can use this technique to draw anything, still life objects such as flowers in a vase, landscapes, or in this case, a portrait of the human face. I'm using a screenshot of my face, but you could use a photograph, a mirror, or have a friend or family member sit for you. You have to find a starting point. I like to start in the center of the face at the nose, but you can start anywhere you like. You want to work very slowly. Your eye should follow the contour or outline of your subject slowly, looking for details while your hand traces slowly at the same pace without interruption. Remember, the goal is not to look at your paper and at the same time not to lift your pen. This is a great tool for developing hand and eye coordination. The reason we do these exercises is to help us see better, to train our eye. I like that in this exercise you aren't focusing on the outcome, but instead you are studying your subject more intently. The finished product isn't usually a lifelike representation of your subject, but with enough practice you can produce a likeness. The expressive quality of the lines, and with added color, you are left with a unique and very interesting image.